Okay, this is Ben Jones at the Isle of Wight Festival, and it's day one, and Coco is here from I Blame Coco. Nice to see you.
Lovely to see you.
Thank you very much for your time. The sun is coming out. I was thinking it was going to be a welly boot weekend, but I think with the flip-flops could be out before the end of the weekend. Do you take much thought, consideration about your festival outfit prior to doing one of these things?
Not really. I sort of find what I've got clean in my suitcase.
It's as simple as that.
Yeah, we don't have a washing machine in the transit van, so
it's only a matter of time.
It's only a matter of time.
How is your first major festival of the summer going?
Really well. I'm enjoying myself. I've got a bit of a cold, but apart from that, I'm doing good.
You've grown up in backstage areas like this, I guess, your entire life. Is it still a thrill? Does it still give you a buzz to turn up and do something like this?
I haven't actually. I didn't grow up in festivals. I grew up in the countryside at school.
So you didn't. You were very much separate to what your dad did for a job, and you didn't really do any of that kind of stuff.
No, not really.
Because I know some of the artists, they sort of take the families tend to go on tour, but that wasn't the lifestyle for you.
I stayed at home and studied.
Do you know, wise word, the only person I know who probably has done. Who would be in your dream festival lineup if you could pick? Let's have three artists, I guess.
Headliners.
Dead or alive, yeah, your Dead headliners for the Coco Fest.
Ian Dury, Hendrix, Plan B, Mike Snow and Robin.
That's a very good festival. I know I'd come.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'd come.
Maybe I should make it happen.
Yeah, you should.
Bring it back from the dead.
Pull a few strings, make a few calls. I mean, yeah, the only thing that wouldn't happen would be Hendrix coming back. But who are you making a beeline for? Obviously, you've got a fair bit of time to check out some of the artists. Who are you going to see?
I'm hoping, I don't know whether they've played or not, Shakespeare Sister. But we've got to go in a bit. I've got to go home and get well, which is really unfortunate.
So you're going to miss Jay-Z? You're gonna miss Florence and the Machine. Oh my word!
I have to sacrifice that for my health.
Sucks to be you, I guess.
How
is the next day off shaping up? When is it, and what have you got planned?
My next day off.
Yeah.
Is 2 weeks from now. I'm going to go on a walk on the heath. Go to the pub, probably. Sleep the rest of the time.
Was it always
a
natural progression for you to do something like this, to have a career in music?
Music's always been an obsession of mine. And I think it's something I've always wanted to do.
Any more festivals? What else are you doing for the rest of the summer? Where can people see you live?
We're doing
Where else are we doing?
Beach Break Live. Beach Break Live in Leckley.
Glenethley.
Reading and Leeds, Glastonbury.
Yeah. Oh, what's occurring?
Latitude, Love Box.
We can't hear you on that bar.
All I will say is she's got a busy summer, a very busy summer. Listen, good to see you. For those people who haven't maybe heard your music yet, can you kind of describe the sound that you have and what kind of music you make?
The music is very much electronic rock, sort of with dance elements, and the lyrics are sort of quite melancholic and
I guess people could probably make up their own minds when they see you at one of the myriad of festivals you're doing this summer. Don't work too hard, get rid of the cold, and enjoy yourself this evening.
That's good advice, thank you.
Nice to see you, Coco. Thanks for your time.